Yes, that's it. And that was how Akwa United defeated Niger Tornadoes 3-2 via penalties to be champions of the first edition of the ITO Cup. Even right here in the studio, Otupong and the chairman couldn't watch. That's how nerve-gripping it was with penalties. Let's talk about Coach Abdul Maikaba. How much influence has he brought into this Akwa United team?
Yeah, he's a great coach. He brought so much influence to the team, discipline-wise and everything. And he's a coach that have confidence in his players. And he's a coach that also, each match, each game that we played, we change our tactics because of the opening that we are facing. He's a great coach, and with him, we are going far in this continent.
Let's listen to Coach Abdul Maikaba. He was here on Friday, and he was showing respect to his opponent because we also had Coach Abubakar Mohammed in the studio. But he was so confident that Akwa United will win the trophy. Let's listen to him after Akwa United when we're right back.
I'm so excited winning my first trophy in my first year in Akwa United Football Club. Very, very difficult. And but I have the belief that at the end we'll win. I told my players, even in during penalties, when we lost the first one, I told them we'll surely win because we have worked for it. So I'm happy psychologically they don't get disturbed, and we were able to overcome it and win at the end.
Well, I feel great. I want to thank God for making this a huge success for us. I really thank God. Just like Friday night, I told you, we're going to leave this trophy. Yeah, we can do well because our team have improved very, very, very well. You see, the way we play is quite different from the way we play past seasons. And we have a lot of things to prove that we are good team to go to the continent.
So that's it, Coach Abdul Maikaba and Ariwa Chukwu Emmanuel. They were both here on Friday, and as you listen, Ariwa Chukwu said we're going to win the trophy, and they did. Let me talk to you, Chairman. Let's talk about the league and the progress we've made in the league so far. You like where you see league football in Nigeria?
A lot of improvement, a lot of it. So much work has been put in. The LMC progresses every day. It wasn't like this in the past. Now it's getting better, especially when people say, let me say this. This year, for instance, you're going to get a better representation in the continent. It's high time we did that. In the past 4 or 5 years, Nigeria has not done well. But we are getting there by the day with Akwa United. Thank God for that. Plateau United, MFM, and
Eyimba.
I think we're going to get a good representation. The league in Nigeria is tough. And if you succeed, if you get out of the league in this country, you should be able to do well. You should be able to do well in the continent. I believe so.
You know, it's going to get tougher holding on to players. You know, does Akwa United have the sort of ambition that these players will see that will not make them start thinking of leaving?
I think this is what we needed. The first, when you go, Nigerian players typically, it's not like a Maikaba that qualified last season with Wiki and then said, look, let me go to Akwa United because they're ambitious. If you qualify for the continent, you attract players. I can say this to you. Today, I and Maikaba, we talked to about 5 players who came to us and they wanted to be part of Akwa United, and in sanction, we spoke to them. When you go into the continent, players want to come to you. You know, so you can, for instance, everyone that we have now will stay. The only problem we have is the calendar that we still have to align with the European League. Suddenly, you find yourself in a situation where 3 of your players are going for trials at the time that the league is still on. But for those that are here, those that we have in this club, I can tell you, except we tell them go, they will not want to leave. You know, we hold on to our players, and you can take that back to what we've done so far. I mean, my priority is the welfare of players. You know, welfare is not about money. Welfare is about well-being. Welfare is about having your players in mind, their challenges, are your challenges, treat them like your children. My players are happy. You know, you saw what happened there. That was a vote of confidence when they tossed me up and my wife was screaming.
I know. I was like, well, wait a minute, hold him. And you know, whenever players do that, they do with so much confidence, I forget the fear.
It's a vote of confidence. We take over players. Welfare is paramount in our club.
And now let's Otobong confirm that. He says you guys are happy. Is it true?
Yeah, we are very much happy because the governor is behind us, right behind us. No matter, there's nothing that we look for that the governor doesn't give to us so that we can do well. And I so much give thanks to God that at least we have give something to show for it, for all the support that is given unto us. So we are very much happy.
I was going to tell you not to look at his side. That
is just... No. I mean, you can confirm that we may be just one of the very few clubs that don't owe. We don't owe salaries, we don't owe bonuses, you know, we pay as that when due. And that's a credit.
What about the promises from 2015? Has it been fulfilled?
Fulfilled to the last letter. He's a landlord. He's gotten his cash. He's gotten his cash.
And that should be a good source of motivation. So when your colleagues just want to go to Libya, go to Kazakhstan to play football, where you can get it better and have a fulfilled life?
Well, you know, in football, you have to play and move out. So people have their choice of playing and moving out. So.
If you took me to that place, I don't know where to be. Let's talk about that final match. Some fans are complaining that Akwa United and Niger Tornadoes didn't give us the sort of final we should have seen. And both sides were scoring goals left, right, and center from when we started till the final day. We didn't see any goal. What was responsible? I've heard the pitch. I've heard because they were curved balls. It was too fast. What happened on that final day?
That's exactly how final is supposed to be. You don't have to, the final doesn't have to end up with 4-0 or 5-0. It will not show like it's a final. So with the tie that we play 0-0, end up in penalty, shows it's a great final because the both sides have to be careful because any goal that goes into your net, that's the end of it. So everybody have to be careful. And secondly, the pitch was another issue for us, and the ball that they brought in was that not good for us too.
Was it the ball too fast, or because it was a new ball that was being introduced?
It was just a new ball that was introduced that day.
Paul, let's talk about the continent now. I love the fact that I call you Paul, it just comes to me like
yeah, I love you.
Let's wrap up the show this way. Now it's a serious business. Akwa United back to the continent again. Are we going to consolidate on this team? What are the plans now going forward?
Let me give a lot of credit to Tornadoes. That's not the Tornadoes that we play in the league. I keep on saying this. A much improved team. Credit to their coach and everything. They've also let us know, I mean, Makaba, post-league, post-ITU Cup discussions, we need to maybe 3-4 players, not too many, block the holes. The journalist that I am, we are going to approach it better. Journalists will keep on screaming. You have an opponent, the draw has been made. You don't find out whether they play on artificial turf. You don't find out what weather. You don't find out which plane will take you there. We should be prepared. The draw is made today. I get my opponent, I'll go to work. Thank God again for the government that we have. We have to make bookings in time. We have to, if possible, send out somebody. How is the weather? This jersey that we have, we cannot use short sleeves. Little things matter. Even to the point where, who is going to be my referee? If you have a referee from a certain country, like not Africa, he expects the ball to flow. If I have a referee from Cameroon, he wouldn't mind some,
physical
so
play.
I want to use my experience to be able to put those things in place. And when you do that, you are prepared. Because that is one of the things we are going to bring in. And then, like you said, this time around, quality players, quality coach, good ambience. I mean, my governor landed on YouTube and said, look, we play on grass. And now we had an artificial turf. Those balls, we saw them for the first time. We didn't train with them. You know, and then we use a wing play. If my cover doesn't mind, I mean, my number two and number three, they overlap. Yeah. And then we found a stadium that was too small for us.
Yeah.
And then suddenly we could not operate. But it's not an excuse, you know, but that, definitely that wasn't our best match. Would I like it? It wasn't our best match. I mean, I died on Sunday. Only this morning, I watched your TV program, went to the stands and bought newspapers, big banner on the front page of the point that I knew that, yes, it was true after all. Yeah.
I like that ending. Thank you so much, Otobong, for coming around. Thank you, Paul Bassey, Chairman, Akwa United Football Club. You guys, all the best
in
your future endeavor.
Thank you.
That's it. The champions of the first edition of the ITO Cup.